Good morning, students. Today in SST we are doing chapter 4 and your topic is modern means of transport. And today we will discuss about these three topics, okay? Land transport, water transport and air transport. These three are the main means of transport in present days. Okay, so we will discuss about these three topics, okay? Land transport, water transport and the air transport. Okay, let's start the topics. Just open this page 25, page number 25 from your books. Hope all of you have the books in front of you. Okay, the first one, that is land transport. We all know what is land transport, right? Water transport is also is very well known to us, and air transport is also the very easy way for the transport. Okay, modern means of transport in India. We all need to travel from one place to another. Sometimes we walk to nearby places to travel to places that are far from home. We need vehicles like bicycle, car, bus, train, aeroplane or ship. So we all need to travel from one place to another. So to travel or to move from one place to another, especially in distance places, is we require some mode. We can't use our foot, we can't use the bipedal locomotion, yes? So we need some means of transport, and these means of transport like bicycle, car, bus, train, aeroplane or ships. These are the examples underlined, okay? Underline the second lines, okay? These vehicles that help us travel long distances are called the means of transport. So these vehicles like bicycle, car, bus, train, aeroplane, ships, these are the means of transport. Understood? I'm repeating once more, what are the means of transport or what is means of transport? We all need to travel from one place to another, okay? So for that, to travel from one place to another, we require some means, some mode to move from one place to another, like bicycle, car, bus, train, aeroplane, ships, etc. So all these are known as the means of transport, okay? We use different means of transport to travel to different places. These means to transport carry people as well as goods. We choose different means of transport on the basis of distance we would travel, the time available and the money we can spend. So there are three main means of transport. Overall, there are three main major means of transport. One is land transport, underline. Next is water transport, and the last one, that is the air transport. Now we'll discuss about land transport. Some vehicles travel on land. Most of the means of transport that travel on land, you can see in the pictures also, they are called the land transport. So like scooters, cars, buses, trains which run on the lands, these are called the transports, especially for the land and land transport. Trains are very good means to travel. Trains, which is considered as the cheapest means of land transport, okay, that carries men as well as goods. To board a train, we must go to the railway station. For the inquiry, for the query of the railways, trains, we have to go to the railway stations. Look at the pictures here. These are the means of transport. Train is train. Next is car. Next is truck. So these are the examples of the land transport, okay? Examples of land transport example of land transport like bus. You can add buses, car, train, etc. So these are the examples of the land transport. There are many different types of trains. Some are passenger trains and some trains carry goods and express trains travels very fast from one city to another. So there are two types of trains that we all know. One is passenger trains which carry the passenger mainly, and another is the goods train. Okay, passenger trains or train you can write, or goods train. Passenger, it carries passenger and goods, specially used for the goods to carry heavy loads. So there are two types of trains. One is passenger train, another is goods train. In big cities like Delhi and Kolkata, there are metro trains also. Underground trains are called the metro, which is considered as the fastest means of travel. The metro trains. Okay, these are the underrail. It is known as underrail also, underground trains also, and especially it is mainly found in the big cities, metro cities like Kolkata, Delhi, Mumbai, etc. They are super fast trains that help people travel within the city in a very little time. So metro trains takes a very little time to travel, especially for the long distances. So these are all are about the land transport. So what is land transport? Land transport is one of the means of transport. Okay, so some vehicles that travels on land only, for example scooter, bus, car, trains, etc. Okay, especially trains, which is used in two sense, one to carry the passenger and another to carry heavy loads, goods train. So there are two types of trains. One is passenger trains and another is goods train. Okay, and there's another kind of train that especially found in the metro cities, big cities. Metro cities means big cities like Kolkata and Delhi, Kolkata, Mumbai, especially in the southern countries also. So these trains are called the metro trains. These are the underground trains, and it is the cheapest and fastest means of transport, land transport. Understood? Hope you have understood this land transport. It's very easy. While I'm explaining here, you can note it down in your copy also, okay, or you can write in your book also. Next one is the water transport. So what is water transport? Water transport means the transport via waters, water bodies, okay, oceans, seas, etc. It is the oldest means of transport. Especially water transport was developed during the British times. Yes, so India was under dominance of the British country. So to travel, they use the water transport. Okay, so it is the oldest means of transport. Underline, among these three transport, water transport is the oldest means of transport. Vehicles like boats, ferries and ships travel on water. So as I explained you just now, few transport, few modes that travels on land and few that on the water also. So vehicles like boats, ferries, ships that travel on land. There are motor boats also that use fuel engines to move fast, and there are sailboats that use force of the wind to move forward. So boats, the kind of boats like sailboats, yes, engine boats, so the ferries, the ships, these are the example of the water transport. the example of water transport. Example of water transport, especially boats, boats, ships, ferries. These are the example of the water transport. Okay, it is the oldest means of transport. Passenger ships carry people from one place to another. Yes, you know, to the types of ships are there, passenger ships and goods ships, especially that is called cargo also. Okay, so passenger ships, they carry people from one place to another. These days people travel on cruise ships for leisure. Goods that are huge and heavy are sent by the cargo ships. Underline the term cargo. Cargo ships. Okay, the heavy loads, goods that are transported through our ships, that is called the cargo ships. The place where the boats or the ship dock is called a port. Underline this whole. The place where the boats or the ships that dock halt, stop simply, is called a port. P-O-R-T, port. Like airport, that is the seaport. Okay. So goods are also loaded and unloaded here in port. Here means in port. Cities that have waterfronts are called ports cities, like Visakhapatnam and Kolkata. Especially ports are found in the are located in Visakhapatnam and Kolkata, especially Kolkata. We have a natural port in Kolkata, Haldia port. Okay, so water transport, this is the another type of modern means of transport. It is one of the oldest means of transport, and the example of water transports are boats, ships, ferries, etc. Here also there are two types of ships. One is passenger ships, another is cargo ships. Passenger ships carries people, it helps people to move from one place to another. Cargo means it carries or it transports the loads, especially the goods. And the cities in India, especially Kolkata and Visakhapatnam, we have a natural port. Next one is air transport. Okay, in the book only it is given, just look at the diagrams, the pictures. Okay, the types of ships, cruise ships is there, sailboats, yes, ships, port, look at the port. Port means the place where the boats or ships dock. Okay, let's look at the pictures. Okay, next one, the third one is air transport. We all know what is air transport these days, yes, and what it means. This is the fastest way of traveling. So earlier it is considered, it is one of the cheapest, you know, mode of transport. But actually it is not the cheapest mode of transport. Yes, definitely it is the fastest means of transport, but it is not the cheapest if we compare among the others. In comparison with these two transports, the air transport is the fastest one, but it is not the cheapest one. Okay, so this is the fastest way of traveling. It saves time definitely, but is expensive. Underline. Aeroplanes and helicopters are the common means of air transport. So nowadays it's very easy for the common people to travel via air. Yes, definitely it is expensive one, but we can prevent time. Okay, there are big air buses also and large aircrafts that can carry both passenger and goods. So air buses, these large aircrafts which we use for both the passengers and the goods. There are cargo planes too. Like cargo ships, there are cargo planes too that carry only goods. Remember the term cargo. Okay, there are cargo ships also and even the cargo planes. Both cargo ships and cargo planes are used to carry heavy goods, heavy loaded materials. To board an aeroplane, we need to go to the airport. Okay, like for the train, we have to go to the railway station. Similarly, to board an aeroplane, we have to go to the airport. Airport. Okay, for air transport. For air transport, we have to go to the airport, and for the rails or trains, we have to go to the railway station. Stations. Understood? Don't be confused. It's very easy chapters. Small chapters, easy chapters, okay, and it's an interesting chapters also. So don't be confused for the some words. Might be it is a new term for you, but it is very easy. Okay, so cargo ships or cargo planes, that both are used to carry goods. Okay, so to board an aeroplane, for aeroplane we have to visit airport. We need to go to the airport. Aeroplanes land and take off from the airport. We all know that. Okay, so aeroplanes land and take off from the airport. We have here in Baghdura, we have domestic airport. We do not have the international airport. Baghdura, that is just near by our schools, that is our domestic airport. Okay, so helicopters are useful in traveling short distances quickly. Another example of air transport, that is the helicopters, that specially used to travel for the short distances. They also help in rescue operations in areas affected by the flood and in jungles or mountains where people are trapped, because they can land in places where aeroplane cannot. So helicopters mainly used in rescue operations. Okay, mainly used by the disaster management team. Okay, so both the helicopters and aeroplanes, these are the means of air transport. Aeroplane, that is used for the long distance traveling, and the helicopters, that used for the short distances. And helicopters are mainly used for the rescue operations. Hot air balloons, underline the term, is also a mode of air transport. So it is shown in your pictures also, diagram. This is hot air balloons, yes, filled with air. That is also a mode of transport nowadays. It is mostly used for entertainment, especially in the parking areas. Yes, we can see this kind of transport, air transport, just for the entertainment. Okay, understood? These three mode of transport is very easy: land transport, water transport, and air transport. The next one, okay, so let's see the examples also given in your book. The difference between the aeroplanes and the helicopter. This is the oldest planes, okay? This is not the modified one, this is the modified one. So next one is public and private transport. This is another new term for you. Some vehicles carry many people at the same time. They are called the public transport. So public transport are those means of transport which are used specially for the people or by the people. Okay, that mainly for the people, public only. They are called the public transport, like city buses, yes, auto rickshaws and trains. So these are the public transport. Okay, underline the examples also. There are two type of transport. One is types of transport. It's not means of transport, the types of transport. One is public transport. Another is private transport. Those transport which are used by the people, so many peoples at a time, at the same time, these are called the public transport. For example, city buses, aeroplanes, trains, etc. So these are the examples of the public transport. Okay, so some vehicles carry many people at the same time, so these are called the public transport. So public transport examples: city buses, aeroplanes, trains, etc. Some vehicles are meant for personal use only. So some vehicles that are used for our private use, personal use only, such as private car, yes, so choppers. So these are the private transport. So some vehicles are meant for the personal use, they are called the private transport. Underline, okay, they reach up to our door steps. Here it is the examples of bullock cart, that the earlier mode of transport we have studied in our previous lessons. Yes, bullock cart, tonga, okay, these were the means of transport in earlier days. These are the buses. Okay, so there are two types of transport, one is public and another is private. Vehicles are either run by engines or pulled by the living beings. Some examples of the vehicles that are pulled by human beings and animals are bullock carts. Yesterday only we have discussed all this term, yes, in our previous classes. Tongas, bicycles, cycle rickshaws, underline, and paddle boats, that is the boats. Okay, so these are the examples of the types of vehicles. Okay, vehicles like scooters, cars, buses, trucks and aeroplanes have engines. These are the engine based vehicles. They can travel faster than vehicles pulled by humans and animals. Definitely the vehicles which are run by the engines that travel faster than those vehicles which are pulled by humans and animals. So underline the examples of the vehicles pulled by human beings: bullock carts, tonga, bicycles, cycle rickshaws, paddle boats, etc. These are the vehicles which are pulled by the human beings and animals. And the scooters, cars, buses, trucks, aeroplane, these have engines run by the engines, and definitely these travel faster than those vehicles pulled by the humans and animals. Hope you all have understood the chapters clearly. I'm requesting you all to learn in details this chapter, not once, twice, thrice, then you'll get the clear idea about this topics. Okay, it's a very easy and interesting chapter. Thank you, students. Let's do the exercise of same chapter, that modern means of transport. Okay, number one is write true or false. Number one, we use different means of transport to travel to different places, that is true. okay. Next one, to board a train, we must go to the airport. That is false. We must go to the railway station. Number three, cargo planes carry only goods. That is correct, true. Number four, vehicles like boats, ferries and ships travel on land. Number four, false. Number five, vehicles are run only by engines. That is false. Number six, scooters, cars, buses, trucks and aeroplanes have engines. That is true. Number B, fill in the blanks. We all need to travel. Number two, vehicles like scooters, car, buses and trucks have engines. Number three, to board a train, we must go to the railway station. Number four, goods that are huge and heavy are sent by cargo ships. Next one, number five, aeroplanes land and take off from the airport. Number six, water transport is the oldest means of transport. Now, come to the next, that is your question's answer, number C. What are the means of transport? The vehicles that help us to travel long distances are called means of transport. Number two, name the three types of transport. Answer, the three types of transport are land transport, water transport and air transport. The next one, what is a port? The place where the boats or ships dock is called a port. Next one, number four, how are helicopters useful? Your answer, helicopters are useful in traveling short distances quickly. They also help in rescue operations in areas affected by flood and in the jungles or mountains where people are trapped, T-R-A-P-P-E-D, trapped, because they can land in places where aeroplanes cannot. Okay. Number five, what is public transport? It's very easy. Vehicles which carry many people at the same time are called public transport. Example, buses, auto rickshaws and trains. Question number six, why do vehicles like scooters and cars travel faster than the bullock cart? Answer, vehicles like scooters and cars travel faster than the bullock carts because they have engines. Okay. Then the last one, that is the picture study. So in the pictures here, you have to identify and you have to write the name. So first one, that is land transport. Next is, it's a ship, so definitely it's a water transport. And the next one, this is air transport. So students, you can get all these answers, exercises from our school website also. Thank you.